ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಯ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ನಿರ್ಮಾತೃಗಳು ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಲಿಕೆಯ 52ನೇ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತಿದೆ. ಕೆಲವು ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಯಿಂದಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ತಡವಾಗಿ ಆರಂಭಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಕ್ಷಮೆ ಕೋರುತ್ತೇನೆ. ಇಂದು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಸಂಶೋಧಕ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರ ಕುರಿತ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ನೀಡಲಿರುವ ನಾಡಿನ ಸ್ಮಾರಕಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ತಮ್ಮದೇ ಆದ ಛಾಪನ್ನು ಮೂಡಿಸಿರುವ ಮತ್ತು ಹೊಸ ಅಧ್ಯಯನಕಾರರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿಯಾಗಿರುವ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ ಅವರ ಪರಿಚಯ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡಲು ನಮಗೆ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆ ಎನಿಸುತ್ತದೆ. ಅಶೋಕನ ಶಾಸನಗಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧವಾದ ಐತಿಹಾಸಿಕ ನಗರ ಕೊಪ್ಪಳದ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲರು ದಿನಾಂಕ 1950 ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ 16ರಂದು ಜನಿಸಿದರು. ಶ್ರೀಯುತರು ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧ ಇತಿಹಾಸಕಾರ, ಕವಿ, ಸಾಹಿತಿ ಮತ್ತು ಆದರ್ಶ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ಹೆಸರುವಾಸಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದ ಶ್ರೀ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಸುಮಂಗಲಾ ದೇವಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಅವರ ಜ್ಯೇಷ್ಠ ಪುತ್ರರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಶ್ರೀಯುತರು 1975ರಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾಲಯ ಧಾರವಾಡದಿಂದ ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಮತ್ತು ಶಾಸನಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ದರ್ಜೆಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಸ್ನಾತಕೋತ್ತರ ಪದವಿಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದುಕೊಂಡರು ಮತ್ತು 1984ರಲ್ಲಿ ನವದೆಹಲಿಯ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಸರ್ವೇಕ್ಷಣದ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಯಿಂದ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ತನ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ನಾತಕೋತ್ತರ ಡಿಪ್ಲೊಮಾ ಪದವಿಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಪಾಟೀಲರು 1979ರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಎಸ್ಐನ ಮಿಡ್ ಸದರನ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತ ಇದು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತಾಂತ್ರಿಕ ಸಹಾಯಕರಾಗಿ ಸೇವೆಗೆ ಸೇರಿ 1985ರವರೆಗೆ ಸೇವೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅನಂತರ ನವದೆಹಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಎಎಸ್ಐನ ನಿರ್ದೇಶನಾಲಯ ಮತ್ತು ದೆಹಲಿ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ 1986ರಿಂದ 2002ರವರೆಗೆ ವಿವಿಧ ಹುದ್ದೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇವೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆನಂತರ 2002ರಿಂದ 2009ರವರೆಗೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ವೃತ್ತದಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪ ಅಧೀಕ್ಷಕ ಪುರಾತತ್ವವಿದರಾಗಿ ಸೇವೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಿ 2009ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿವೃತ್ತರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲರು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ವಡಗಾಂವ್, ಮಾಧವಪುರ, ಹಂಪಿ, ಬನಹಳ್ಳಿ, ಬೇಲೂರು, ಚಿತ್ರದುರ್ಗ ಮತ್ತು ಹರಿಯಾಣದ ಬನಾವಲಿಯ ಉತ್ಖನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನವದೆಹಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಎಎಸ್ಐನ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವು ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ಬೋಧಿಸಿರುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಶ್ರೀಯುತರು ಅನೇಕ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ನಿಯೋಗ ಮತ್ತು ಕಾರ್ಯಾಗಾರಗಳಿಗಾಗಿ ಮಾಲ್ಡೀವ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಪೇನ್, ಸಿಂಗಾಪುರ ಮತ್ತು ಚೀನಾ ದೇಶಗಳಿಗೆ ಭೇಟಿ ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲರು 2010-11ರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಮಾರಕಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಪುರಾವಶೇಷಗಳ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಮಿಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಸಂಯೋಜಕರಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಪುರಾವಶೇಷ ಮತ್ತು ಕಲಾನಿಧಿ ಅಧಿನಿಯಮ 1972ರನ್ನು ಪರಿಷ್ಕರಿಸಲು ರಚಿಸಿದ ಆರ್.ಎನ್. ಮಿಶ್ರಾ ಸಮಿತಿಯ ಸದಸ್ಯರಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು 2010ರಿಂದ 2013ರವರೆಗೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ನಿರ್ದೇಶನಾಲಯ, ವಸ್ತು ಸಂಗ್ರಹಾಲಯಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಪರಂಪರೆ ಇಲಾಖೆಯ ಸ್ಮಾರಕಗಳ ಸಂರಕ್ಷಣೆಯ ಆಡಳಿತ ಮತ್ತು ತಾಂತ್ರಿಕ ಸಮಿತಿಯ ಸದಸ್ಯರಾಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಯನಿರ್ವಹಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. 2015ರಿಂದ 2017ರವರೆಗೆ ಇಲಿಸಿಟ್ ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ವೆಲ್ತ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್, ಇದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆ ನಡೆಸಲು ಪಾಟೀಲರು ಟ್ಯಾಗೋರ್ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ಗೆ ಭಾಜನರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲರ ಸುಮಾರು 80ಕ್ಕೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಸಂಶೋಧನಾ ಲೇಖನಗಳು ದೇಶದ ಹೆಸರಾಂತ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ನಿಯತಕಾಲಿಕೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಕಟಗೊಂಡಿವೆ. ಅಲ್ಲದೆ 1997ರಲ್ಲಿ ಪೂರ್ಣಿಮಾ ರೇ ಅವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ದೆಹಲಿ ಎ ಬಿಬ್ಲಿಯೋಗ್ರಫಿ, 2014ರಲ್ಲಿ ಪೂರ್ಣಿಮಾ ರೇ ಅವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ರಿಮೆಂಬರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ವಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬಯೋಗ್ರಫಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಕೆಚಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮತ್ತು 2020ರಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಶಾಂತಕುಮಾರಿ ಅವರ ಗೌರವಾರ್ಥವಾಗಿ ಎಸ್ ವಿ ಪಾಡಿಗಾರ್ ಮತ್ತು ವಿ ಶಿವಾನಂದ ಅವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ನ್ಯೂ ಫೆಸಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಟೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಪಿಗ್ರಫಿ ಹಾಗೂ 2020 ದಿವಂಗತ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕ ಸಿ ಮಣಿ ಅವರ ಸ್ಮರಣಾರ್ಥವಾಗಿ ಕಪಿಲಾ ವಾತ್ಸಾಯನ್ ಮತ್ತು ರವೀಂದ್ರ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಇವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಏಷ್ಯನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡಾಲಜಿ ಅಸಿತಯಾನಗಳೆಂಬ ಕೃತಿಗಳನ್ನು ಪ್ರಕಟಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಿ ವಿ ಪಾಟೀಲರ ನಿವೃತ್ತಿ ಅಥವಾ ವಯಸ್ಸು ಅವರ ಅವಿರತ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಅಡ್ಡಿ ಆತಂಕಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಂದಿಗೂ ಅವರು ಅದೇ ಚೈತನ್ಯದಿಂದ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಅವರನ್ನು ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭಿಸಬೇಕೆಂದು ಕೋರುತ್ತೇನೆ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಸರ್.
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಸೀತಾಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ, ತುಂಬ ತುಂಬ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು. ಈಗ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಭಾಷಣವನ್ನು ಅವರ ಕುರಿತು ಅವರ ಜೀವನ ಚರಿತ್ರೆ ಬದುಕು ಬರಹವನ್ನು ಪರಿಚಯಿಸಲು ಆಹ್ವಾನಿಸಿದ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಯ ದೇವಕೊಂಡಾರೆಡ್ಡಿ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರು ಹಾಗೂ ಸರ್ವರಿಗೂ ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ಆಭಾರಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಗ್ರ್ಯಾಚುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಬಯೋಗ್ರಫಿಕಲ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಮೆನ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದಿ ರೈಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ಲಿ 18th, 19th, 20th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡೀಡ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಕೊಲೋಸಸ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 20th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ. ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕೇವಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳುವುದು ಬಹಳ ದುಸ್ಸಾಹಸ ಅಂತ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಆದರೂ ಅವರ ಪರಿಚಯ, ಅವರು ಮಾಡಿದ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ನಾನು ತಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳಲು ಬಯಸುತ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಅವರ ವಿವಿಧ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳನ್ನು ನಾನು ಎರಡು ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ವಿಂಗಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಅವರು ಭಾರತೀಯ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಸರ್ವೇಕ್ಷಣೆಯ ಜೊತೆಗೆ 1950-80 ಮಾಡಿದ ಕೆಲಸಗಳು, ನಂತರ 1980-1997 ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಷನೋಗ್ರಫಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮರೀನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ ಫಾದರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮರೀನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಚಿರಪರಿಚಿತರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಎರಡು ಕಾಲಘಟ್ಟಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅವರ ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟವಾದ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ನಾನು ತಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳಲು ಬಯಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲನೇದಾಗಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರ ಕಿರು ಪರಿಚಯವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಮಾಡಲು ಬಯಸುತ್ತೇನೆ. ಶಿಕಾರಿಪುರ ರಂಗನಾಥ್ ರಾವ್, ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್, ವಾಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎಮಿನೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ನೋನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಔಟ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟು ಹರಪ್ಪನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್, ಇಂಡಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಟ್, ಮರೀನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ, ಪ್ರಿಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಮ್ಸ್. ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಶಿಕಾರಿಪುರ ರಂಗನಾಥ ಅವರು 1-7-1922 ಆನಂದಪುರಂ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಹಳ್ಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಗರ ತಾಲೂಕಿನ ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜನಿಸಿದರು. ಶ್ರೀ ಹುಚಾರಾವ್ ಮತ್ತು ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಕಮಲಾ ಅವರು ಅವರ ಮಾತೃಪಿತರರಾಗಿದ್ದರು. ಅವರು ತಮ್ಮ ಆರಂಭಿಕ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಜೇಡಿ ಎಂಬ ಹಳ್ಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಗಿಸಿ ನಂತರ ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ SSLC ಪಾಸು ಮಾಡಿ ಮೈಸೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ 1988 ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಹೈ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸು ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಕೂಡ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ₹15 ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಂತರ ಅವರು MA BA ಆನರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇನ್ 1941 ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದಟ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಸರ್ ಹಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್. ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟೆಡ್ ಈಸ್ MA ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾಗ್ಪುರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇನ್ 1977. ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗ್ಲಾಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅವಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ದಿ ಜವಾಹರ್ಲಾಲ್ ನೆಹರು ಫೆಲೋಶಿಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಆನ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ 1981. ದಿ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಸೂರ್ ಕನ್ಫರ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಹಿಮ್ ದಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಟ್ರೇಚರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಲೋಥಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ ಸಿವಿಲೈಜೇಷನ್. ಇದು ಅವರ ವಿದ್ಯಾಭ್ಯಾಸದ ಒಂದು ಕಿರು ಪರಿಚಯ. ಅವರು ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಪದವೀಧರರಾದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಬಹುಶಃ ಬಹಳ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆಯೋ ಇಲ್ಲೋ, ಎಮ್ ಎನ್ನ ಮೈಸೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 6 ಮಂತ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ಹಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ದಿ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರಾಜ್ಯುಯೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿ ಪೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಟ್ ಹೊನ್ನಾಳಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಎಟ್ ಶಿವಮೊಗ್ಗ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೊರಬ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಸೈನಿಂಗ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿ ನಾಗ್ಪುರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಸೊ ನಾಗ್ಪುರ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ ಎಡಿಟರ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಜಾಯಿನಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಹಿ ವರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಅಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನಿ ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಟು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಟರ್ನಿಟಿ ಇನ್ 1948 1948ರಲ್ಲಿ. ಅಂದಿನ ಬರೋಡಾ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಇಲಾಖೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ತಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನವನ್ನು ಪುರಾತತ್ವಿಕ ಜೀವನವನ್ನು ಆರಂಭಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ತಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ 1947ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ನೊಂದ ನಂತರ ಬಹುತೇಕ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಭಾರತ ದೇಶದ ಒಕ್ಕೂಟಗಳೊಂದಿಗೆ ಹೊಂದಾಣಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತವೆ. ಆ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ಕೂಡ ಈ ಬರೋಡಾ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಇಲಾಖೆಯನ್ನು ಭಾರತೀಯ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಸರ್ವೇಕ್ಷಣದಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಲೀನಗೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತದೆ. ಆವಾಗ ಇವರು ಡೆಪ್ಯೂಟಿ ಸೂಪರಿಂಟೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಇವರಿಗೆ ಪದವಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನಂತರ ಇವರು ಪದೋನ್ನತಿಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದು ಸೂಪರಿಂಟೆಂಡೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಬರೋಡಾ, ನಾರ್ದರ್ನ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಆಗ್ರಾ, ಸದರ್ನ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಚೆನ್ನೈ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ನಾಗ್ಪುರ್, ಸೌತ್ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಔರಂಗಾಬಾದ್, ಮಿಡ್ ಸದರ್ನ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್, ವಡೋದರಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮಾರು ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. 1980ರಲ್ಲಿ ಇವರು ತಮ್ಮ ಸೇವಾನಿವೃತ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಕ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೈಲ್. ಇವರ ಪುರಾತತ್ವಿಕ ಯಾತ್ರೆಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ವಿವಿಧ ಹಂತಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಬಹುದು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್, ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಮ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಟ್ ಮರೀನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವೆಂಚರ್ಸ್, ಈಚ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಕ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಓಪನ್ಡ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ವಿಸ್ಟಾಸ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಜಾಯ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಡೆಡ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯೋಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್. ಹಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ 1954 to 1980 ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎಎಸ್ ಐ ಇನ್ ಗುಜರಾತ್, ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶ್, ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು, ಆಂಧ್ರಪ್ರದೇಶ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಟೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಹಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಷನೋಗ್ರಫಿ ಗೋವಾ. ದೆನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ 1980 and 1997 ಹಿ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ಶೋರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿ ಕೋಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್. ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್, ಬಿಫೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್. ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲನೆಯದಾಗಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರಾವ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ 1947ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಬಂದ ನಂತರ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶವು ಪಾಕಿಸ್ತಾನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಭಾರತ ದೇಶಗಳಾಗಿ ಎರಡು ದೊಡ್ಡ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಗಳಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮುತ್ತವೆ. ಇದರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಪುರಾತತ್ವದ ವಿಷಯವಾಗಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ದುಃಖದಾಯಕವಾದಂತಹ ಸಂಗತಿ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ದಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ದಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಹರಪ್ಪನ್ ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹರಪ್ಪ, ಮಹಂಜೋದಾರೋ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ಯಾಲಿಯೋಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಹನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಗಂಧಾರ ಕಲೆಯ ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಬಿಂದುಗಳಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ತಕ್ಷಿಲಾ, ಚಾರ್ಸಾಲಾ, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಪಾಕಿಸ್ತಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊರಟು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಹರಪ್ಪ ಅಥವಾ ಸಿಂಧು ನಾಗರಿಕ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಯ ಅವಶೇಷಗಳನ್ನು ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ಹುಡುಕ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಥ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಸರ್ವೇಕ್ಷಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಈ ಹರಪ್ಪ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಯ ಅವಶೇಷಗಳನ್ನು ಹುಡುಕಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಗುಜರಾತದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಹಿ ಗೇವ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಟು ದಿ Harappan sites and the exploration he carried out in Gujarat. So what he did was, the loss of the Harappan sites was immediately fulfilled by Dr. Rao when he discovered the major Harappan sites like Bhargatav, Harappa sites like Lothal, Kota, and late Harappa sites like Meg and all that. And after that, he was transferred somewhere to in Agra circle, that he discovered the rock shelters in Madhya Pradesh and Paleolithic sites. Of course, while he was heading the excavation branch at Nagpur, he has explored the Tamil Nadu, Andhra, and Karnataka. And especially in 1964, he explored the Tamil Nadu, and he discovered the famous site of Neolithic culture known as Payampalli, where he which serves as a index site for several years so far as the Neolithic culture is concerned. Then in ade reetiyagi en martar andre modledu, he was the first exploration. What he wanted to do is to determine the generics and sequential relationship of the painted pottery culture found in Karnool region with the Neolithic and Chalcolithic of the Godavari and Narmada Valley, and those with the Neolithic culture of the Palar Basin. ಎರಡನೇದು ಒಂದು ಮಹತ್ತರವಾದಂತಹ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ವೇಷಣೆಯನ್ನ ಕರ್ನೂಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಪಾಲಾರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಪೆನ್ನಾರ್ ನಾರ್ಕಾಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ಅವುಗಳನ್ನ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಸಂಬಂಧವಿತ್ತೆ ಈ ಪ್ರಾಗಿತಿಹಾಸ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ಅವರು ಅನ್ವೇಷಣೆಯನ್ನ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೋಲಾರ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ನಿಯೋಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಮೆಗಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆದಂತಹ ಮಾಲೂರು ತಾಲೂಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬನಹಳ್ಳಿ, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆಂಡತ್ತೂರ್, ಟೇಕಲ್, ಕೆಂಡತ್ತಿ ಅಂತ ಹಳ್ಳಿಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಪುರಾವಶೇಷಗಳು, ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ನಿಯೋಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೆಗಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನೂತನ ಶಿಲಾಯುಗ ಮತ್ತು ಬೃಹತ್ ಶಿಲಾಯುಗದ ಅವಶೇಷಗಳನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ. ನಂತರ ಅವರು ಗೋಕಾಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ಉಡುಪಿಯಿಂದ ಸರ್ವೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬನವಾಸಿ, ಹೊನ್ನಾವರ, ಗೋಕರ್ಣ, ಉದಯವಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ನೂತನ ಶಿಲಾಯುಗದ ನೆಲೆಗಳ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಆರಂಭಿಕ ಕಾಲದ ಕೆಲವು ಅವಶೇಷಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. 1975-76 ತುಂಗಭದ್ರಾ ನದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಂಪಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಠಲ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನದ ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮಸಳೆನ ಗುಡ್ಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ನೂತನ ಶಿಲಾಯುಗದ ನೆಲೆಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ. ಇದು ಸಂಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಅನ್ವೇಷಣೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರೇಷನ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಂತರ ಅವರ ಪ್ರಾಮುಖ್ಯತೆಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ಅಳಿಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು ಅವರು ಮಾಡಿದಂತಹ ವಿವಿಧ ರೀತಿಯಾದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕಲ್ವೇಷನ್ಗಳನ್ನು. ಸುಮಾರು 22 ನೆಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ವಿವಿಧ ರೀತಿಯ ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಸ್ಥಳಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಉತ್ಖನನವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇ ಹಸ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ 22 ವೈಲ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ASI. ದಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 1952-53, ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಮ್ರೇಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂಡಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ್ವಾರಕಾ ಇನ್ 1979-80. ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ದಿ ದ್ವಾರಕಾ ವಾಸ್ ದಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಟೆಡ್ ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಬಿಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ASI. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ chronological chart that I have prepared, what I know, what I could do. Of course, this excludes the marine archaeological excavations conducted when he was heading the National Institute of Oceanography. So let me quickly go through each one of these, the characteristics of the excavations, what he has done. For the convenience sake, I have divided his excavations into the Harappa cultures, excavations on the Neolithic and Megalithic cultures, and then early historic, then the ancient metallurgy and mining, and then the ancient port towns and the marine archaeology. So under these different heads, I will just give a brief the outlines of the cultural sequence and importance of those excavations he carried out between 1952-53 to 1980. In this long spell of nearly 30 years, he has excavated nearly 22 sites. So we can begin with the Harappan culture, that is Rangapur. He excavated between 1953-54, and this was the first site after the partition which gave the entire perspective of the Harappan culture, what was deprived then, till then, for which we lost the famous sites of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro on account of the partition. So the large scale excavation he conducted at Rangpur in district Surendragarh of the Gujarat, it revealed three cultural phases: Mesolithic, Harappa, late Harappa and transition phase of the Harappa, and then lustrous redware deposits. So this served as an index site for the entire Harappan culture studies that carried out right from Rajasthan, Gujarat, Haryana, Punjab, up to the Alamgirpur in the UP. So this was the first site that gave the a comprehensive picture of the Harappa after the 1947. And then he published these results in the Ancient India number 18 and 19, a very beautifully illustrated reports. Some of the pictures I see, this is the excavation that was in going on, the various kinds of debris, Rangpur, and then the various kinds of structures that you see. And then this is the mud brick structures and the big drains that was the highlight of the Harappans. And then, of course, we come to the most coveted or the most the sought excavation, what Rao did in his throughout career. He dug about almost 8 years from 1954-55 to 1963. ಇದು ಅವರ ಬೃಹತ್ ಮಹದಾಸೆಯ ಒಂದು ಉತ್ಖನನವನ್ನು ಲೋಥಲಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹರಪ್ಪನ್ ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಟೌನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದು ಗುಜರಾತಿನ ಅಹಮದಾಬಾದ್ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರ್ ಹರಪ್ಪನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಿನ ಅಂಶಗಳು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ದೆನ್ ಫೋರ್ಟಿಫೈಡ್ ಆಕ್ರೋಪಾಲಿಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸಿಟಡೆಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಲೋಯರ್ ಟೆನ್. ಸೊ ನಾವೇನು ಹರಪ್ಪ ಮೊಹೆಂಜೊದಾರೋದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಳೆದುಕೊಂಡಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತು ಲೋಯರ್ ಟೌನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಪರ್ ಟೌನ್ ಅನ್ನು, ಅದನ್ನು ಈ ರಾವ್ ಸಾಹೇಬರು ಈ ಲೋಥಲಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ. ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈ ಸೇಸ್, ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ ರಿವೀಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರ್ ಹರಪ್ಪ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಡಿಸೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ದೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಫೋರ್ಟಿಫೈಡ್ ಆಕ್ರೋಪಾಲಿಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸಿಟಡೆಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಲೋಯರ್ ಟೌನ್. ಅಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲೋಥಲ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವೆಲ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ಡ್ ಡಾಕ್ ಯಾರ್ಡ್. That is a Lothal dockyard and then a warehouse, several hundreds of seals, rice, bajra. These are the most important antiquities. And all these antiquities gave rise to the site museum at Lothal in Sargwala. So Rao got a very name and fame because of this Lothal excavation, in which he termed the discovered a well-designed dock. So this is the aerial view of the Lothal excavation done for almost 8 seasons. And then this is the Lothal dock which he discovered. And then this is the warehouse where the cargo used to come and go. And these are the various kinds of the structures, houses, drains and others. And then these are the various kinds of seed. What I would like to emphasize here, the Rao's continuous staying in Baroda, in Gujarat area, and excavating large number of exploration and excavations, what he conducted during his stay, perhaps these seals, the hundreds of seals what he got, must have instigated him to take the decipherment of the Indus seals. That's what I feel personally. These seals have a little contribution for him to take up this, one of the finest Indus studies ever known in the Indian archaeology. Then the next site is Bhargata. Next in the Bhargata Martare, he excavated it in 57-58. Idu southernmost Harappan settlement agiddu Kim River nadiya dandeyalliddu Bharuch jilleyalide Gujaratina. Illi trial pinks anna haki sanna pramanada ondu utkhananavanna martare. Illi mukhyavagi namage eradu tarada samskrutika ghattagalu kandubarutte. Harappa idanna punaha distinguished into mature Harappa, amale late Harappa anta martare. Then the finally the late Harappa anta period 2 or medieval ge bartare. Then the some of the potteries and other antiquities that has been found in Bhargatav. Then mundina ondu Harappa irutakkanta avasheshagalu irutakkanta nelayanna utkhadisiddu Megham in 1957-58. He excavated Megham, another late Harappa site on the Narmada estuary in the district Bharuch. The trial digging revealed a small burial pit enclosed by a pisse and containing 2 high-necked jars, a dish on stand, a flat dish in addition to jar, etc. So this is dish on stand, the most typical of the Harappan ceramic industry. and these are the various kinds of the pottery what he could encore. Of course, there was a little controversy regarding the spread of the Harappa. People used to think that no, it was confined only to Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh. It never penetrated into the Deccan. Of course, the Rao excavated in 1974-75 along with the M.N. Deshpande when he was there as a director general, of course. And then it is in Ahmednagar to ascertain the cultural horizon of a cache of four solid bronze figures. ಈ ದೈಮಾಬಾದ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದ್ಸಾರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಕಂಚಿನ ಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳ ಒಂದು ನಿಧಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಗೇಷನ್ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಿಯೋಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಹೊರೈಸನ್ ಕಂಪೇರಬಲ್ ಟು ಟಿಪಿಕಲ್ ನಿಯೋಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೌತ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿ ಲೋಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ Malwa, Jorve, along with Malwa culture and a number of furnaces were all divided. And people still feel that Daimabad has an influence of the Harappa, and it has just reached the borders because one or two other sites in Maharashtra have shown the Harappan influence, especially the Jorva, Malwa and others. So these are the structures and the pottery and the terracotta figurines. And these are the bronze holders that the Daimabad has given. These are the solid bronze elephant and horse and riders. And this is one of the finest metal technology of the early period that attests to. And then after these things, we can move on. After Harappa, we will go to the Neolithic and the Megalithic cultures of the southern India mostly. And this particular period between 1964 and 67, 68 or 70, whatever was there, it was a formative stage so far as the Neolithic cultures are concerned. See, we did not have a clear picture of the Neolithic, what people thought. The Neolithic culture, the earlier they used to say that only the introduction of pottery and the Neolithic access was the hallmark. Of course, then gradually the concept of the Neolithic went on changing. And then they found it should be a ceramic without a pottery. And then finally, the economy and agriculture should be the criteria. And even otherwise also, people thought that the Neolithic culture should be without metal. That is, pre-metal or without the metal content should be regarded as a Neolithic culture. In this context, the Payampally then in 1964-65 assumes the significance of the Rao's excavation. So Rao did it, the excavation in 1964-65 and then in 67-68, the Payampally, it is in North Arcot district of Tamil Nadu. And the interesting was the absence of metal and the presence of horse gram in the Neolithic levels. So this is what the metal-free cultural horizon till then was recognized as the one of the criteria to decide the Neolithic cultures of the then prevailing. So a few C14 dates also were there. And then this provided a firm datum line for the southernmost non-metal using Neolithic people. So this is the importance of the Payampally excavation as early as 1964 and 65, what Rao has did. And then these are the terracotta objects, and this is the cultural horizon of the Payampally, the one which is, you see the axes, bowls, and terracotta ram. This is the pure Neolithic, what we can say. And then, of course, we get the megalithic culture. And then the another Neolithic site, what he excavated was Sastewadi. It is in Maharashtra. So in 1971-72, he took trial excavations at Sastewadi, which is on the northern bank of the river Mula in district Pune. And he wanted to find out whether Sastewadi could be a meeting place of the southward expansion of the Jorve and the northward expansion of the Neolithic cultures of the Krishna Valley. So this was his purpose of excavation. And the digging on the western slope of the mound revealed three cultural periods. Neolithic culture characterized by the burnished grayware along with painted Malwa wares and the Jorve ware along with the parallel sided blades, and then copper fish hook and the Muslim Maratha times. So this is how he wanted to check whether the regional influences is there, whether from south and north these are any you know, correlations and cultural contacts is there. So this is what he made an excavation and effort there. From this, we will enter into the early historic archaeology, which gives one of the firm footing. And I want to say that the early historic archaeology in especially in Karnataka is still in infancy. Of course, in North India, it has been very, very well established in North India, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab, the early historic archaeology, mainly because of the Cunningham and his legacy, followed by even today, much more of the archaeological sites, especially the Cunningham, because he followed the sites to be identified, especially in the Buddhist Jataka stories and Buddhist chronicles. So this is how the North India has more historical sites excavated than in South. Of course, in Tamil Nadu and in Andhra Pradesh, little work has been done. So far as Karnataka is concerned, very little work has been done. And Rao tried to fill up those things with the Deccan. And the first site, he excavated Singanapalli and others also. And Teher also, he excavated the Neolithic, Megalithic sites. And these are the various kinds of the burials that we find in the megalithic culture. And this is the burial at Tehur, which is in Maharashtra again. And these are the various kinds of the pottery. And then we, as I said, we will enter into the early historic cultures, what Rao has excavated. The first site he excavated was Amreli. It is in district Amreli of the same name in Gujarat. The local mound was known as Gholiwat Timbo, that it was continuously occupied from 1st century BCE to the 8th century AD. That was his findings. And in that also, he had little, we have the little evidences of the Chalcolithic culture also. The most interesting findings were the post-cremation burials of the 1st century BC and the funerary vessels. The other important finds include the coins of Kumar Gupta, lead and silver coins of the Western Kshatrapa rulers, stone plaques depicting god and goddesses, and the seal of Siladitta. So this is how the early historic, or his journey with the early historic, begins with the Amreli in Gujarat. These are some of the excavated structures, the coins and the seals and everything, you can see. The next one is in Kaneri. He excavated the early historic sites. In 6970, he excavated cave number 25, the Kaneri, which is known as the ancient Krishnagiri in district Mumbai. And he wanted to know what exactly is happening in the cave. Because in the caves, these Buddhist caves used to, the monks and the others used to reside. And there was a retaining wall built in the veranda. The Rao was astonished to see why in the natural rock cut cave this wall was built. So he thought, he wanted to have an excavation there and find out what exactly is there. So this digging in the Kaneri cave number 25 brought to light three occupational levels belonging to single cultural period, ranging in time from 1st century to the 9th century AD. This was the time span. And what he could find there was furnaces, crucibles, slags, iron slags, that these were found. This indicated that the monks not only engaged in preaching and practicing the religious discourses, but also were engaged in crafting the metals and their subsequent trade also. These other interesting finds, red polished ware, coins were also found. So it convincingly proved that the Buddhist monks of Kaneri were not only engaged in the religious preachings, but also were masters in the metal crafting and their trade also. Of course, these are the trial trenches what he dug out in the Kaneri. And these are the Brahmi letters and the Kaneri antiquities and all that. Of course, the most sensational excavations he did so far as the early historic archaeology is concerned in Karnataka, the twin temple, towns known as Aiwale and Pottadkal. There is a lot of story behind this. You know, this particularly when he was heading the Aurangabad circle, during this period almost, the St. Xavier's 400th birthday exposition was held in Goa. So the Rav thought that so much of the entire convents and churches of Goa were rebrushed to celebrate the event of that 400 years disposition of the Saint Xavier's body. So immediately it struck so much so that even Aiwale Badami Pattadkal are much more than this. It's our own culture. He took it as a challenge and he started working on this restoration of the Aiwale Badami Pattadkal. So here he had to clear the debris. He has to excavate the areas to find out the working level of the temples. And then once he wrote in an article, which I don't remember, he says that nearly 100 tons of the debris was removed from the Badami Aiwale alone. And the whole idea of Rao was to make the Aiwale as a temple village or a temple city. For that, he took a lot of pains. Not only the fortune favored Karnataka also, because immediately after the Aurangabad circle, he came to Bangalore circle. And so the work of Aiwale and Badami Pattadkal went unstopped for almost 5 to 6 years when Rao was heading the Aurangabad circle and the Bangalore circle. For your kind information, till the Bangalore circle was formed, the monuments of Karnataka were looked after by three different agencies. One, Aurangabad circle, North Karnataka, except the districts of Raichur, Gulbarga, Bidar, which were under Hyderabad, and rest of the old Mysore was under the Madras presidency, the Chennai circle. So under these circumstances, Rao took a challenge for the Aiwale and Pattadkal. Not only he conserved the monuments there, but also excavated, because he was forced to get the working levels of almost all the temples there. So he excavated some of them, and fortunately what he found was that even before the Chalukyans could raise the temples in those twin cities, the Shatavahanas has occupied those areas. That's what he proved. But on one side, it brought to the temples to the limelight, and then he also proved that there was a habitation by the Shatavahanas. So at Aiwale, what he did was, underneath the foundation of Ambigar Gudi, remains of a brick built temple, rectangular and plough, was exposed. Ambigar Gudi kelagade mattondu devasthanavittu. Ade riti Huchappayyana ಮಠದ ಆವರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರ್ಲಿ ಚಾಲುಕ್ಯನ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂಗಾರದ ಪದಕಗಳು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮಗೆ, ಬೆಳ್ಳಿಯ ಬಳೆಗಳು, ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ರಿಂಗ್. ಬಿಲೋ ದಿ ಚಾಲುಕ್ಯನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್, ಶಾತವಾನ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎನ್ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹುಚ್ಚಪ್ಪಯ್ಯನ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್. ದ ಡಿಗಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಖಾನ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ರಿವೀಲ್ಡ್ ದ ರಿಮೇನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ದಟ್ ವೇರ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಯರ್ ಟು ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಖಾನ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್. Another interesting feature noticed was that these temples were heavily damaged by the great floods. Similarly, in Pattadkal, he excavated in the Sangameshwara temple complex. There he found again the typical Shatavahana below the working level. So this is how the excavations are going on. It also gives an idea how the monuments of the Badami Aiwale Pattadkal not only were encroached, but the huge deposit of the sand, earth and debris accumulated over the years, because they were totally neglected. See, this is how the Pattadkal brick structure of the Shatavahana period of the Jaina temple, this is in Sangameshwara temple, the whole debris was cleared. Here at the earliest level, we could get the the Shatavahana levels. And then we can, Rao did not leave alone, but he also focused his attention on the medieval archaeology. The first site he excavated in the medieval period was Chittorgarh Fort. To ascertain the Mahasati tradition of the Rajput ladies, all you know about the Mahasati tradition, I need not speak more. Rao undertook an excavation at Mahasati area in the fort at Chittorgarh in 1958-59. The digging laid bare the four small shrines, ashes, charred bones, and an interesting structure found was the paved platform where stood the Sati stones. This is his finding so far as the Chittorgarh is concerned. We can have the temple's remains and all that. Of course, we will turn to another, one of the most fascinating subject of the early medieval archaeology, that is the Vijayanagara metropolis. You know, we can have a little background here. In 1975, when Professor Noorul Hasan was the then education minister, he set up three national projects to undertake the archaeological research on medieval towns to understand the town planning and socio-economic perspectives. I repeat, the town planning and socio-economic perspectives, and the three important sites that were selected were Fatehpur Sikri in Uttar Pradesh, Champaran in Gujarat, and in Hampi in Karnataka. So Uttar Pradesh, the Fatehpur Sikri was done by several agencies like Gao, with the Aligarh Muslim University was given the responsibility. And in Champaner, the Aryan Mehta was given the responsibility to excavate that. And we are proud to say that in Karnataka, Dr. Rao had the distinction of inaugurating the Hampi National Project in the year 1965. And so for two years he continuously excavated 75-76, and he took the large-scale excavations in Vithala Bazar and the area between King's Audience Hall and Mahanomi Dibba. And we are proud to say that since 1975-76, the excavation is ongoing in the Hampi. Perhaps this is one of the longest period ever known in the archaeological sites of throughout the world. For the last almost 45 years, the excavation is going on in one way or the other, and the credit of inaugurating the excavation at the medieval site of Hampi undoubtedly goes to Dr. S.R. Rao. So since then, what happened in Hampi, you all, the scholarly world knows. After Rao's departure, the other L.K. Srinivasan, Narasimhaya, and then from State Archaeology, Nagaraj Rao, they all combined, now even Dr. Mishra also, V.K. Mishra, and then the Hampi project was started, in which the national and international scholars took place. Since the 80s, the Hampi has been a focal point of the medieval research ever known throughout the world. So these are some of the excavations what he carried out. This is one of the much known subjects, so I will just skip off what has been discovered there, just make the glimpses of what Rao has done the excavation there, the drainages, the Homakunda, and Brahmi inscription is a limestone panel having the Brahmi inscription of the 1st-2nd century AD, and in Vithala Templex, the ancient Bazaar Street was laid out, and here the 350 copper coins of the Balakrishna and other type of the Krishnadevaraya coins were found. And then, of course, his most fascinating topic that now we are going to come up is the ancient port towns. You know, ever since this is Hampi, these are all various pictures of the Hampi excavation. Then Rao did not even leave the ancient mining and metallurgy also. In Kalyadi in 1976-77, when he was here in the Bangalore Circle, Kalyadi is another very important site where he excavated to certain weather tells heaps of the ancient mining were formed anciently or represent slags of heap, and four tubes in situ at, in a row was burst and a small excavation was done here, Rao and Dr. Poonacha. And then these are the ancient mining activities that has. Of course, he later expanded his horizon. Then he wrote a beautiful paper on the ancient mining metallurgy and technology encompassing right from Harappa up to the medieval times. A very lengthy paper has been published. Then his most favorite, the second part of his assignment, that is after the retirement of ASI, which he made him to be an international figure, which fortunately we call him as the father of the marine archaeology. Of course, it had its seeds in Karnataka. In 19 earlier, he had the area from Gokarna to Udupi. He has surveyed along with Dr. R.V. Joshi, another well-known geoarchaeologist. And then they have found that there was a rise in the sea level. And this made him to think the entire coastline of India was submerged due to the rise in the levels. So he started focusing on the ancient port towns. And one such port town is the Kaveri Pattinam. And he excavated there. And lot of information he could get. He excavated this between 62, 63, 64 and 65 in the Kaveri Pattinam. It was a famous town of the early Chola rulers. The small-scale excavation at Kiliyaru revealed the massive brick platform and two wooden posts planted near brick structure, which indicated a raft and the backwaters for anchoring the boats. And another nearby locality in Velian Irupu, remains of fragmentary brick walls and two platforms were traced at different levels, indicating four structure levels. The other interesting finds were the copper coins of Rajaraja I, two modeled royal heads of the typical tradition. At Vanagiri, the remains of a brick structure was found, almost semicircular in plan, which was exposed to be a reservoir fed by the inlet channel from the river Kaveri. At Palaneshwar, a Buddhist vihara was found. So these are the various kinds of the associated structure, raft, jetties, and all these things he noticed in the Kaveri Pattinam. And this is the various kinds of structures that he found. And you can see the lanes, the walls, and others. So this ignited, this made him to think more and more about the marine findings. And he actually then set forth his mission after the retirement of the from the ASI. So the another important aspect of the Rao's life career is the conservation. No parallel for him so far as the conservation of monuments is concerned. He had a rare insight in understanding the problems and challenges with the conservations. And he was adept. He was so cute. And that this monument needs this kind of particular treatment. So that's why he was able to conserve the monuments across the country, wherever he was posted, whether it is in Agra, whether it is in Madhya Pradesh, whether it is in Gujarat, whether it is in Rajasthan, or in Karnataka, Goa, Tamil Nadu, wherever he was there, he had given a more, such a wonderful methodology for conservation. That's why he is considered as one of the top-ranking conservator, adept in understanding the problems and challenges of the conversions, of the overcoming them. So what I am going to show you here is some of the important names of the places in Rajasthan, the palaces of Fatah, Ranakamba, Padmini and Rana Singh, Tower of Victory, Tower of Fame, temples of Samadhishwara, Kalimuthu, Satistone, Chittorgarh, group of temples at Ninal, Deeg Palace, Deeg One Masjid, beautiful wooden palaces are there, and all wonderful to hear. Then in Uttar Pradesh, Fort Itmadullah Tomb, Taj Mahal in Agra, the tomb of Sheikh Salim Chisti in Fatehpur Sikri, Akbar tombs in Sikandara. Then in Madhya Pradesh, Parvati temple in Nachana, which is one of the earliest temple. Then group of temples of Khajuraho, which the Chandelas have built it. It has its own art and architectural tradition. And then, of course, his another second home after Karnataka is Maharashtra, where he has conserved Ellora Caves, Ajanta Caves, Patan Devi Temple, Brahmanical Rock Cut Temple, Kaneri Caves, Elephanta Caves, Karla Caves, Hill Fort of Shivaji, all in Maharashtra. And then churches and convents of Goa. Of course, I have spoken much about the early Chalukyan monuments at Badami, Aivale, Pattadkal. You know, in fact, he invited personally, if I remember very well, he invited personally the then governor, Mr. Shri Dharamveerji. He took him to Aivale and he had a plan to rehabilitate the entire village of Aivale and make it as a village of temple. You know, interestingly, the villagers are also ready. Unfortunately, after Rao's departure, of course, efforts have been made. Still, if you parse it, the villagers are ready to move out from the Aivale village, and they feel pride in saying that this, our village is maybe called as a village of temple village. And then when he was posted in the Bangalore circle, Vaisala monuments, Halabid, and of course the famous Dwarkadisha temple is another home for him, the Lord Krishna. And then in Tamil Nadu, the Brihadeshwara temple, Shore temple, Jarakanteshwara, these are some of the most important monuments which he could conserve it. Then, of course, I will show you the then in 1968 to between 1968 and 1970, these are some of the photographs. This is Pattadkal Kashi Vishveshwara temple. One side you can see how the debris is there. Other side after the debris clearance. And this is Sangameshwara temple before and after. And then this is Kunti temple. You can see how the houses were built. And you can see the walls relieving the panels. You know, that's why I said more than 100 truckloads of these kind of debris was removed from Aivale itself alone. You know, the total cost of the what Rao has delivered, he has delivered the presidential address in the Chalukyas of Badami way back in 1977. He writes that, but very few may know the horrible condition of the early Chalukya temple 6 years ago. They were encroached upon by ugly looking modern hutments, and some of them even converted into cattle sheds and private kitchens. Many of the beautiful carved edifices were not even approachable. Mounds of rubbish caused nausea to visitors. The Archaeological Survey of India, therefore, has taken vigorous steps to remove modern accretion and throw open to the famous temples of Virupaksha. And he further writes that an amount of 30 lakhs has been spent around the gardens, building, and all those in 1970s. So this is how he gives the presidential address in the Chalukyas of Badami seminar held in way back in 1978. Rao had, you know, the very fascination for Badami, Aivale, and early Chalukyan monuments. In fact, he has built his house in the same style of the Chalukyan, which resembles like a monument. And this is, see, Aivale, Kunti, and Durga temples after the clearance. The other photo, what you saw, this is how the ugly rubbish things are there over the temple. And this is how after clearing. Then Aivale temple, Ladkan, I said, there were another 4 temples here, and it was accumulated and affected with the floods of sand for 2 deposits, and the whole area was cleared and it was made to be very presented nicely. Of course, another important turning point so far as the museums are concerned in Karnataka, while conserving the monuments either in Aurangabad circle or in the Bangalore circle, Rao had encountered lot of sculptures, antiquities, architectural fragment, inscription while conserving and preserving the monuments like places like Badami, Aivale, Pattadkal, Lakkundi, Bagale, and Banavasi. You know, he thought that let us have a small museum raising the sculpture within the ambience of these monuments. So he was successful in implementing that. This is one of the most precious and important turning points so far as safeguarding the antiquarian wealth of the monuments concerned. And if I remember, the Sir John Marshall, way back in 1900, when he was the director general, he writes, the antiquities or the sculpture should not be removed from the ambience of the monuments which they belong. Otherwise, they are likely to lose their relevance. So keeping in that spirit, Rao had actually made these small sculpture sheds, and many of them today have become the full-fledged museums, the Badami, Aivade, the Badami Museum. Nobody will recognize Badami because in the available space in the cave, he has made a small, you know, museum. And from the outside, you can't recognize it. It is a museum. But that was his forethought, that let us not, harm, let us not deteriorate, let us not affect the ambience of the monument. So he thought this way. So Badami and Aivade today have become the full-fledged museums. So, of course, the next part of the two important aspects of Dr. Rao, which have brought the fame, name and fame, of course, I just make a passing reference because these are the two specialized subjects which need the specialist to discuss all these things. However, S.R. Rao made significant contribution to the study of Indus civilization and decipherment of the Indus script. As I said, the number of seals he encountered in Lothal and other Harappan sites in Gujarat stimulated him to undertake this research on the Indus script. Perhaps this is what I feel. He argued that Indus language, Indo-Aryan, and the script started as pictorial writing and evolved into phonetic and alphabetic around 1700 BC. This is his conclusion. Of course, there are views against and the for this. So that's what I say, that it is a subject which needs to be thoroughly discussed in a separate platform. So also the marine archaeology. Now, after retirement from ASI, Rao turned his attention toward the scientific investigation in marine archaeological studies in Indian waters. A project funded by the National Science Academy and implemented through National Institute of Oceanography, Donapala, Goa, where he served as emeritus scientist between 1881 to 95 and advisor 1996 to 97. During this tenure, he had his team undertook as many as 12 marine archaeological expeditions in and around Dwarka, Bedwarka, Kaveri Pattinam, and Lakshadweep. And he has discovered so many, early historic part and other right from 1400, 1500, 4000 BC and all that. But as I said, it requires a specialized discussion. So I just give a hint that he undertook the marine archaeological studies and what he surveyed the Gokarna area and the Kaveri Pattinam. The light we lit on this interest in the ancient port town ultimately culminated in forming a marine archaeological unit which was hitherto unknown in 1980s. And this made him to earn an epithet, almost the father of marine archaeology in India. And of course, such a long span of lasting for more than 5 to 6 decades, naturally, the distinguished honors are bound to come and have flowed. Rao was honored with many academic fellowships and distinction for his meritorious contribution to Indian archaeology. He was awarded the prestigious Jawaharlal Nehru Fellowship for undertaking research on the Indus script that was in the year 1977. The University of Mysore conferred on him the Doctor of Literature for his monumental work, Lothal and Indus Civilization, which he published in 1981, and he was honored with the Samaja Bhushana and then Pracha Vidya Sharada. Of course, the greatest act is the Mythic Society Gold Medal for the Scholar of the Year that was awarded him in 1981 at Bangalore. Karnataka Rajyotsava Prashasti was confirmed to him in 1985. The FIE Foundation Award Ichal Karanji in 1991. of course, for his marine archaeological contribution, the World Ship Trust Award UK in 1992 and the Gupta Foundation Award in 1994. And when the Archaeological Survey of India celebrated in 2012 the 150th year of its establishment, very few scholars, the stalwarts, the yester years were honored, and Dr. Rao was one among them. He was honored in Bangalore itself, along with Ramesh Kotraya, and Dr. Punacha was also awarded that in that. And of course, this is what the prestigious awards that he was confirmed. And Rao has authored more than 50 to 60 research publications. Of course, I am not going to list out those, but I am only concerned here with the publications in the form of the books. So his first Kannada book is in Bharatiya Puratattva in 1961, and Ardha Itihasika Samskrutiya, it is in Gujarati in 1960. Of course, Amreli Ekshatrapa Gupta Town, which was brought in 1966. The Lothal and the Indus Civilization, 1973, which fetched him the honorary doctorate degree from the University of Mysore. Of course, his famous excavation results have been brought in two bulky volumes known as the Memoirs of the Archaeological Survey of India, that is number 78. It's entitled as Lothal Harappan Port Town, that was he conducted excavation between 1955-62. Of course, the traditional paintings of Karnataka with B.V.K. Shastri, because he was so intimately associated with the Chitrakala Parishad. Then the decipherment of the Indus script he brought out in 1988. And the most discussed, the need of the day, which most of the visitors thought that I am going to deal something about the Dwarka, because so many calls I had received. And unfortunately, I'm not a specialist, as I said several times. So it needs the most famous book of the Lost City of Dwarka was published in 1999. And Aksharam, the Alphabet Gallery, because he established the Alphabet Gallery in Tirupati. And he was also the, you know, advisor to the several museums, Manjusha in Dharmasthala, and then the Keladi museums. And he penned his own experiences, that is reminiscences of an archaeologist in 2008. And the language and script of the Indus civilization in 2001. So this is the most important books that Dr. Rao has penned throughout his life. And so ultimately, as the destiny, everyone has to leave a heavenly abode. Dr. S.R. Rao left for heavenly abode on 13/1/2003 at Bangalore. We salute with reverence Dr. S.R. Rao, an archaeological colossus of the 20th century. Of course, this brings to the final phase of my presentation. However, I would like to say a few personal reminiscences of Dr. Rao before I wind up my presentation. I met Dr. S.R. Rao for the first time in 1975 when I was doing my PhD along with my friends like Padigar, and then Dr. Joshi had already completed. Dr. Shivananda was our senior. C.S. Patil was our senior. Of course, our classmate was Batsuri in Hampi University. He was our classmate. And then one Mr. Adnur, he retired as a, you know, deputy commissioner. We were all classmates. The first epigraphical conference was held at Dharwad way back in 1975 under the stewardship of our teacher, Dr. Srinivas Riti. And he was instrumental in arranging the Epigraphical Society. The Epigraphical Society was formed in Bangalore along with Guy and then K.D. Bajpayee, Ajay Mitra Shastri, all like-minded epigraphists. They formed, and then Ramesh, and the first conference was held in Dharwad, and Dr. Rasa Rao and host of others come. So after the conference was over, Dr. Rao was invited to the, you know, for the lecture to be delivered in our classroom, and then he delivered a lecture on the Indus script and the decipherment. He used to put the drawings up, and then he used to tell, then I frankly, I did not understand neither the head or tail. Only my physical presence was there for 1.5 hours. After my MA, my second encounter with Rao was when the Hampi excavation started. So we used to be regularly touch with our teachers, and our teacher, Dr. Sundara, has said, he used to come and attend the antiquarian meetings in the Bangalore. He said, Hampi, the Rao is recruiting the site supervisors to supervise the excavation at ongoing Hampi. So you go and meet him, and such date is the antiquity meeting held at there. So I met him, Dr. S.R. Rao, then Nagaraj Rao was also there. Then he politely said, Mr. Patil, we are coming to an end of the excavation. So when it resumes, I will definitely get back to you. And immediately after a few days, you know, he was awarded Jawaharlal Nehru Fellowship. Even he took the, he was given the special leave. He started working on the Indus script. So in between what happened, I was appointed as a technical assistant and posted in Hampi. And then I went on my transfer to Delhi, I went. And then Rao used to frequently come. And he used to come to our room. I cannot say our chamber. He used to come to us and he used to meet us. And one thing he used to never forget, Patil, I want a hot cup of coffee. Dr. Rao was very fond of coffee. Whenever he used to come to Delhi, invariably he used to come to me, and he used to always was fond of coffee, and I used to get him. And of course, we used to meet him in several meetings. So when I came back in 2002 to Bangalore from Delhi, again, he was being invited as a expert member for the export of the antiquities, issuing non-antiquity certificates. We went on regularly meeting and academic discussion with him. And my last meeting with him was in his house. In 2006-07, we had the conservation camp. So we thought none other than Rao would be the person who could inaugurate the Hampi. So we went to his house. I went personally. Dr. Halkatte was the superintending archaeologist. Then he said, you go and meet him, doctor. Then their family was reluctant. And ultimately, Rao persuaded their family, and Mr. Patil is there. I will he will bring back me safely to the Bangalore. So I took a consent, and on that day he gave me a book of his Indus script signed and date, which I am still keeping it with me. So we took him to Hampi in a special arrangement made along with all the other things, and we got the Hampi conservation camp for the School of Archaeology students. And then his most favorite deity in Hampi is Yantrodharaka Anjaneya. So we made special arrangements, his puja. Then he was so happy. Then he returned to Bangalore. And then relations continued. So this is my personal. And whenever he used to meet, one frequent question he used to ask me, what work you are doing? What you have written, what you have read? So this is how the seniors used to always guide us, goad us, and hammer us, all the three. So this is what the legacy of Rao is there. Many of us students, you know, have adorned the highest positions either in the universities or in the Archaeological Survey of India. So that's what the tribute we can pay. And her daughter Nalini, Dr. Chudamani, Dr. Punacha, and Dr. Halkatte, and his son Bangalore, they have formed the S.R. Rao Foundation. And they had 2-3 seminars and meetings in Bangalore in which I was also present actively. And of course, the S.R. Rao Foundation should come forward to carry the legacy than what it is doing now. I request the Dr. Rao, Nalini Rao, his son Gopal, and other members of the Rao Foundation, Chudamani, Dr. Punacha, and Rao, such a legacy of Rao should be continued in one way or the other. And throughout the year, his various facets of his archaeological investigations and insights, which have been turning points for us. Don't think that what he has done. See, one thing we have to keep it in mind before I say, what he has done between the 50s and 70s was the formative phase of the ASI. We needed the index cited. We needed the index trenches. We needed the insights to carry on the mantle. And what that's what precisely Dr. Rao has done in the, you know, throughout his 20 years of stay. In the finally, I conclude that one sentence, all said and done, Dr. Rao continued the legacy of new trends in archaeological investigation set forth by Wheeler. The explorations, excavations he carried out in search of Harappa had its due impact in locating similar sites in other regions of India. The Harappa lamp he lit at Lothal in Gujarat, beacon in Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra, and finally flamed at Dholavira again in Gujarat. Large number of seals encountered made him to research for well over four decades, and as I said, made him to, you know, this come out with the Indus Script. The painted pottery tradition he discovered again set forth a new tradition of those days, and the C14 dates of the Payampalli gave a firm datum line for the southernmost non-using Neolithic phase. At Thevur, he has shown how this, so a large number of sculptures and architectural members retrieved in excavations while conserving gave birth to the several sculpture sheds. A few of them, like Badami and Daivada, have become full-fledged mates. The discovery of dockyard at Lothal and subsequent excavation at ancient ports towns ultimately culminated in establishing the marine archaeological investigations in Indian waters as one more disciplines of in archaeology, which he carried forward from 1981 to 1997. Sir, we all the archaeological fraternity salute with all our reverence to you, sir. You were a Colossus of the 20th century. So finally, this presentation would have been not possible but for the following persons: Director General ASI, Bangalore Dharwad Hampi Circles, ASI fraternity, so many, you know, his colleagues, his seniors, his juniors, and who have adorned the highest positions in ASI or flourished in either in university, the National Institute of Goa, Mythic Society, which is nourishing the researchers throughout the year. Of course, ICHR Southern too, and S.R. Rao and family, we are grateful. I am grateful to S.R. Rao for all his inputs. And finally, the copyright of the illustrations rests with ASI and the NIO, etc. Finally, sir, I salute once again. Sir, you are one of the colossus, as I repeatedly say, and we all feel proud that we were associated with you in one way or the other. Thank you, sir. Thank you, my audience, for having this patient hearing for me for the last almost 1 hour 15 minutes. I have made an effort to present the overall picture of what Rao has done in his 5 decades of archaeological survey of India, survey with his brief survey, except the 2 fields which requires the special talks. I request either the Academy or the Rao Foundation to come out with 2 special lectures on these subjects. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Dr. Devarkonda Reddy and his team, Itihas Academy, and my friends Aruni Padigar, and so many other, like Punacha, Halakatti, Venkateshaya, Narsimhan, Keshava, my colleagues here in Delhi, Bist, Pandey, and then Margabandhu, who were the associates of J.P. Joshi, M.C. Joshi, who were the associates of Rao, and one of his most favorite friend and philosopher advisor, Dr. Deshpande, with whom I had such a... So all these 2, I salute on behalf of them to Dr. S.R. Rao. Thank you once again.
Dhanyavadagalu, sir. Dr. S.R. Rao avara Dwarka underwater excavations bagge ellaru kelirthive, aadre 22kku hechu neevu heldang puratattva nelegalu avugalnella belakige tandu ಭಾರತದ ಪುರಾತತ್ವ ಲೋಕಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ನೀಡಿದ ಕೊಡುಗೆ ಅಗಾಧವಾದದ್ದು. ಅವರ ಸಾಧನೆ ಅನನ್ಯವಾದದ್ದು. ಅವರ ಮಹತ್ತರವಾದ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನ, ಕೊಡುಗೆಗಳನ್ನ ವಿವರವಾಗಿ ಪೂರಕವಾದ ಛಾಯಾಚಿತ್ರಗಳು ಅಂಕಿ ಅಂಶಗಳೊಡನೆ ಅತ್ಯುತ್ತಮವಾಗಿ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನ ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಟ್ರಿ ಸರ್. ನಿಮಗೆ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಯ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ.
ನಾನೇನು ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಮೈ ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ student associated from 1975. till recently I'm happy. I said, you know, the last visit he gave me a book signed with him putting and all that. I'm still preserving it. There is no parallel for Rao's. What I know, I have shared.
Thank you, sir. Sir, ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಮೆಚ್ಚುಗೆಯ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳು ಬಂದಿವೆ ಸರ್. ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರಾದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಎನ್ ಶ್ರೀಧರ್ ಅವರು ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯಗಳನ್ನ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. So glad to see that the speaker is giving so many very specific details of Dr. Rao's service, explorations and excavations. This is one of the finest talks on archaeology I have heard anta helta idare. Richly detailed and illustrated anta helta idare sir. And one the okay sir. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಲೋಥಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಎ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯನ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಚ್ ಎಸ್ ಗೋಪಾಲ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ಐ ಆಮ್ ಪ್ರೌಡ್ ಟು ಕಂಗ್ರ್ಯಾಚುಲೇಟ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ರಿಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವರು ಶಿವ ಅರುಣಿ ಅವರು, ದೇವರಕೊಂಡಾರೆಡ್ಡಿ ಸರ್ ಅವರು, ಪ್ರಭಾಕರ್ ಅವರು, ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಕೂಡ ತಮ್ಮ ಮೆಚ್ಚುಗೆಯನ್ನ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಪಡಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಸಿದ್ದನಗೌಡರವರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ. ಹಾಗೆ ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳು ಬಂದಿವೆ ಸರ್. ಒಂದು ಎರಡನ್ನ ನೀವು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ. ಪದ್ಮಜಾ ದೇಸಾಯಿ ಅವರು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಸಿಂಧೂ ನಾಗರಿಕತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ದೊರೆತಿರುವ ಮುದ್ರೆಗಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರುವ ಲಿಪಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅಕ್ಷರಗಳನ್ನ ಗುರುತಿಸಿದ್ದಾರ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ಅಂತ.
There is a great controversy. Dr. Rao says it is a pictorial writing and as I said earlier, but the other scholars have not accepted. Still, it is an ongoing discussion. That what I said, I am not an epigraphist. It requires a special discussion on the topic. No doubt he claims that I have deciphered, but it is not at least fully recognized that it is a final. So investigations are going on, and we have to wait till for the final blow has to come. Rao's contribution to his deciphering is very significant. There are various views for and against it. However, he argues that it was an Indo-Aryan, not Indo-European of the Central Asia. This is his view. And he said, the script started as pictorial writing. ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇದು ಪಿಕ್ಟೋರಿಯಲ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ದಿಂದ ಬರೀತಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ. ಅಂಡ್ ಎವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇಂಟು ಅಲ್ಫಾಬೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೊನೆಟಿಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 1700 BC. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಿಕ್ಟೋರಿಯಲ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಂದ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭವಾಗಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅಲ್ಫಾಬೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೊನೆಟಿಕ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯ ಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿಯೂ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ತದ್ವಿರುದ್ಧವಾಗಿಯೂ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯಗಳಿವೆ. ಇದು ಇನ್ನೂ ಸಮಂಜಸವಾಗಿ ನಿರ್ಧಾರ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಪಿಕ್ಟೋಗ್ರಾಫಿನೋ ಅಥವಾ ರೈಟಿಂಗು, ಇದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೇ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ. ಎರಡು ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನ ನಾನು ಈ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಶಿವತಾರ KB ಅವರು ನೀವು ದ್ವಾರಕಾ ಉತ್ಖನನದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ತಾವು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೆ ಒಂದು ವಿಶೇಷ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನ ಏರ್ಪಡಿಸಬಹುದು.
ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಫುಲ್ ಡೇ. ಐದರ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಓಷಿನೋಗ್ರಫಿ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಗೌರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಶೀಲಾ ತ್ರಿಪಾಠಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಅಲೋಕ್ ತ್ರಿಪಾಠಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಚೆನ್ನೈ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಟು ಡೆಲಿವರ್. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಎ ದ್ವಾರಕಾ ಮೆರಿಟೈಮ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಂ ಇನ್ ದ್ವಾರಕಾ. It was on the plan, everything was there. But whether it is not yet materialized, it requires one full session for this. And it is not possible to come out with any conclusion. And moreover, it is a special subject, as I said. You know, you cannot master everything in one stroke.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಸರ್, ಶಿವ ಅರಣಿ ಅವರು ಎರಡು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒಂದು, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಿಂದ ಮೂಡಿದ ಪುರಾತತ್ವಜ್ಞರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ಒಬ್ರು. ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆ ಗುರುತರವಾದದ್ದು. ಇವರ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಗೆ ಸಮಾನವಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಕನ್ನಡದವರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ MS ನಾಗರಾಜ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು. ಇವರು ಕೂಡ ASI ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇವೆ ಮಾಡಲು ಅವಕಾಶವಾಗಿತ್ತು. ತಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಪುರಾತತ್ವಕ್ಕೆ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಮತ್ತು MS ನಾಗರಾಜ್ ಅವರ ಕೊಡುಗೆಗಳನ್ನ ವಿಮರ್ಶಾತ್ಮಕವಾಗಿ ಅವಲೋಕನ ಮಾಡಬಹುದೇ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ.
ಖಂಡಿತವಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡೇ ಬೇರೆ. ದಿ 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 ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಹಿ ಕನ್ಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವೇರ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಎನ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಆಸ್ 22 ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಎನ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಟು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮೇನ್ ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ವೆರಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ನಾಗರಾಜ ರಾವ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಔರಂಗಾಬಾದ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರಾವ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಕ್ರೂಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಮ್ ಎನ್ ದೇಶಪಾಂಡೆ ಹಿ ಸರ್ವೇಡ್ ದಿ ತುಂಗಭದ್ರಾ ವ್ಯಾಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಡಿ ಥೀಸಿಸ್ ದಿ ಅಪರ್ ಚಾಲ್ಕೋಲಿಥಿಕ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಹಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಸೊ ದಿ ದಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಎ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ದಿ 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 ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಪವರ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಪವರ್ ವೆಲ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬಿಗ್ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಸೊ ದಿ ಅಪಾರ್ಚುನಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ASI whereas his contribution and his field is different. One thing is said, but his contribution to major contribution is Hampi, what he brought the George Mitchell and group into the limelight and made it a Hampi project. That is his credit. Of course, in archaeology, after joining the state archaeology, he did only two excavations, Tadakanalli and Kumaranalli. That is the megalithic cultures.
Thank you, sir.
The contributions of the individuals are in totally in a different arena. But he is confined to ASI and then shifted to marine archaeology. So he was only one-sided. So he was concentrating and marking to only one particular field. Whereas Dr. Rao was multifaceted. So this is how we have to analyze. And the work, what they have done in two different spheres, in two different domains.
Sir, Shiva Arani avaru the mattondu prashne. Rao avaru tavu maadida utkhananagala bagge varadigalanna chaachu tappade prakatisidare. ಆದರೆ ಹಂಪಿ ಉತ್ಖನನಗಳ ವರದಿ ಪ್ರಕಟ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಕಾರಣ ಏನಿರಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ
ಸಿ ಹಂಪಿ ಉತ್ಖನನ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 1975 ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇವತ್ತುವರೆಗೂ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ದಿ ASI ದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಗೋ ಆನ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬುಕ್ಲೆಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಬೈ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ನರಸಿಂಹಯ್ಯ ಎ ಡಿಕೇಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಹಂಪಿ ವೇ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಅದಾದ ನಂತರ ಹಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಎ ಬುಕ್ ಬಟ್ ಅದರ್ ದನ್ ದಿ ASI ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಈಸ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಯುನೋ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ದಿ ಪೇಪರ್ಸ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಆಫೀಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವೈಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಆಂಟಿಕ್ವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಂಪಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕವೇಷನ್ಸ್ in position of the state archaeology, a book has come from the pen of Vasudevan, which is published by the state archaeology. But unfortunately, I regret to say that the ASI has not brought out. Dr. Punacha was assigned, and I think he is still working on it. Dr. Punacha was assigned to write the, after the Sannath report, Dr. Punacha was assigned, and still he is working on it. A day may come. But a number of articles are published by the ASI officials, state archaeology and foreigners. This may serve as a reference work for him. But not the report what he thought is published. I agree for that. One should agree for not there and what is there.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಎಂ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಸರ್ ಅವರು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ದ್ವಾರಕೆಯ ಗೈಡ್ಗಳು ಹೊಸ ದ್ವಾರಕೆ ತೋರಿಸುವುದರಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ಸಾಹ ತೋರುವಂತೆ ಹಳೆಯ ದ್ವಾರಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕುರಿತು ತಿಳಿಸೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಎಸ್ಆರ್ರಾವ್ ಅವರ ಶೋಧನೆ ನಡೆದಿರುವುದನ್ನು ಕುರಿತು ತಿಳಿಸುವ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಕರೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುವ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಇಲಾಖೆಯಿಂದ ಏನಾದರೂ ನಡೆದಿದೆಯೇ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದೆ.
ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಸ್ ಐ ನೋ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡನ್. ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ವಿಸಿಟರ್ಸ್. ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ಮೈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಿಸಿಟರ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಪಿಲಿಗ್ರಿಮ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ, ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್, ಹೂ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್, ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್ ಬಿಟ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್. ದಿ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೂ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ಮೋರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದಿ 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 ಟೆಕೀಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ದಿ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್, ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಹೆರಿಟೇಜ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟೂರಿಸಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಹೂ ಕಮ್ ರೀಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆಲ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಟು ವಿಸಿಟ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಮನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದಿ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ವಿಸಿಟರ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್. ಯಾ, ವಿ ನೆವರ್ ಯು ನೋ ಗೋ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಟು ದಿ ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್. ವಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ ದಿ ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ಗೈಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್, ದಿ ರೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ವಿಸಿಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್. ಸೊ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ದಿ ಗೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟರಿಂಗ್ ಸಚ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಸಜೆಷನ್, ಬಟ್ ಎ ಟೈಮ್ ಮೇ ಕಮ್. ಎಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವಿಂಗ್. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಐ ಕನ್ವೇ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ಸ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಂ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ಸ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಆರ್ಅಪ್ಸ್ ಹೂಮ್ ಐ ನೋ ಇನ್ ಗುಜರಾತ್.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಸ್ಮಿತಾ ರೆಡ್ಡಿ ಅವ್ರದ್ದೊಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದೆ. ಅಫ್ಘಾನಿಯನ್ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಸರ್ಗೋನ್ನ ಶಾಸನಗಳಲ್ಲಿನ ಉಲ್ಲೇಖಗಳ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವು ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಸಿಂಧೂ ನಾಗರಿಕತೆಯ ಜನಾಂಗ ಮೆಲೂಹ ಜನಾಂಗ ಇರಬಹುದೆಂದು ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾನ್ಯ ಎಸ್ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ಗುರುತಿಸಿದ್ದಾರಾ?
ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅಂತದ್ದು ಏನೋ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಸಚ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್. ಸಿ ಎಸ್ಆರ್ ರಾವ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ ಸಿವಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಬೈ 1980. ಸೊ ಹಿಸ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟುಕ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಹಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಮರೀನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಲೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ವೆದರ್ ರಾವ್ ಗೇವ್ ಎ ಥಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನ್, ಐ ಡೋ ನಾಟ್ ನೋ, ನಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಮೀ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್, ಬಟ್ ಹೌ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಆಥರ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಆಂಗಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ ಫೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಫ್ಯೂ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ಐ ಡೋ ನಾಟ್ ನೋ ವೆದರ್ ರಾವ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ದಿಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶ್ಯೂರ್ ರಾವ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 1980 ಟು 1997 ಆರ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 2000 ವಾಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಮರೀನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಯಾಲಜಿ. ಹಿ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಹಿ ಫರ್ಗಾಟ್, ಸಾರಿ. ಸೊ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಮೈಟ್ ನೋ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅವೇರ್, ನಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈನ್ಸ್.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಶಿವಾರುಣಿ ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಅವ್ರ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಇದು ಉತ್ತರ ರೂಪವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದು ಎಸ್ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರ ಹಂಪಿ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್, ನರಸಿಂಹಯ್ಯ ಅವರ ಪ್ರಕಟಣೆ ಬೇರೆ ಅಂತ. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಅವರಿಗೆ ತಾವು ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಕಳಿಸೋದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ತಮ್ಮ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನ ನೀಡಬಹುದಾ ಸರ್?
ಖಂಡಿತವಾಗಿ ಎಸ್ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರು ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಬರೆದಿಲ್ಲ. ನೋ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್, ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರಮಣಿ, no individual article has been written by Dr. S.R. Rao except a brief mention in the Indian Archaeology Review for the year 1974-75, 75-76. In these two reviews, what S.R. Rao has done while he was heading the Bangalore Circle, that has been repeated. But no individual paper on the Rao has come on the Hampi as such, as far as my knowledge goes. And if he has written in some foreign journals, I am not aware of it. Most of the scholars write in foreign journals which we are unable to access them. So what happens ultimately, we do not know whether it has been published or not. If it is published, we are unable to have an access to them. Dr. Aruni himself is having a big library, and he can scan his collections and find out, and if he comes across, let him also enlighten me.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳು ಮುಗಿದಿದೆ ಸರ್. ಗಾಯತ್ರಿ ಹೆಚ್ಎನ್ ಗಣಪಯ್ಯ ಭಟ್ ಇನ್ನೂ ಮುಂತಾದ ಅನೇಕ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ವೀಕ್ಷಕರು ತಮ್ಮ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮೆಚ್ಚುಗೆಯನ್ನ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಪಡಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಹತ್ವ ಏನೋ ಮಹನೀಯರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇಂಥ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಒಂದು ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನ ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ತಮಗೆ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನ ವೀಕ್ಷಕರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಯ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ ಸರ್. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಮಾತನ್ನ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಶ್ರೀ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಟೀಲ್ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಲಿಕೆ ನಡೆಸೋದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಬೆನ್ನೆಲುಬಾಗಿ ನಿಂತು ಮೊದಲನೇ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸದಿಂದನೂ ಕೂಡ ನಮಗೆ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಯ ಪರವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನ ತಿಳಿಸ್ತೇನೆ ಸರ್. ನಮಗೆ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು, ವಂದನೆಗಳು ಸರ್.
ಐ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಅನ್ ಅಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ. ಸಿ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಒನ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ. See, whoever does it is all for the welfare of the academy, and we have to bring. See, there are so many persons like Soundararajan. People, you know, what he has, his greatest contribution for Soundararajan. People think he has not done any work, but his greatest contribution for the temples of Chalukyan, early Chalukyan temples, nobody knows. He has produced, he has given three big lectures on Karnataka University. They have been published in the early temple architecture ramification in Karnataka. Likewise, you take Dr. Deshpande, M.N. Deshpande, who was the Director General. His greatest contribution for the Karnataka archaeology is the repair of the accosting system. Now, do you know, in the 1960s and 70s, the Gol Gumbaz had lost its acoustic properties. And Deshpande, when he was the superintending archaeologist of the Bangalore circle, the Aurangabad circle, he took as a challenge for the Gol Gumbaz. He conserved the monument and restored the acoustic properties. And he has discovered so many Paleolithic sites in Malaprabha Basin. Take for Zunar, he has done wonderful work in Malaprabha. R.V. Joshi has done surveyed the entire Malaprabha Basin. There are so many persons who have done but their contribution is limited to one particular field. They also need to be brought under the ITAS Academy. Not one lecture, by combining two, three. Contribution of Joshi, R.V. Joshi, contribution of R.S. Pappu, see, and Malti Shinde. These all have done sporadic work in Malaprabha Basin, Shorapur Basin, Dr. Paddaya. He has not done anything else other than Shorapur and Jevarg area. But their contribution is immense. It's not that only the Karnataka, idi Karnataka namadi illa. Anthavaru mahaniyaru idare. Aa mahaniyarna parichaya maadikodatakkantha enu prayatna maartta idiri. That is great. So I really congratulate the ITAS Academy for initiating this project. But the only thing is, how far the people give it in writing, the articles, what they give lectures. That is important, and it should be brought out. Yesterday, chikkadagli, yenagli, avarna, we should remember them. And if you write about them, and if you appreciate whether plus or minus, and that is the honor that we are paying. That is the greatest tribute that we are paying to our stalwarts. So I think in this direction, the academy will take a serious note of this, and we are always with you, me and my friends.
Sure, sir. Thank you very much. ಇದು ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಾಗತ್ತಾ ಅಂತ ಕೆಲವರು ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಖಂಡಿತ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ನಿರ್ಮಾತೃಗಳು ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ಸರಣಿಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಚಾನೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೇವೆ. ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಸರ್, ತಮಗೆ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ. ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಸರ್. ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ವೀಕ್ಷಿಸಿದ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಕಳಿಸಿ ತಮ್ಮ ಮೆಚ್ಚುಗೆಯನ್ನು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಪಡಿಸಿದ ಎಲ್ಲ ವೀಕ್ಷಕರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಯ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು. ನಮ್ಮ ಮುಂದಿನ ವಾರದ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನಳಿನಿ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್ ಅವರು ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಶ್ರೀನಿವಾಸ ಹಾವನೂರ್ ಅವರನ್ನ ಕುರಿತು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮುಂದಿನ ಸೋಮವಾರ ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗೋಣ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಸರ್, ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ವಂದನೆಗಳು.
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.